الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. So in the book of رياض الصالحين, volume number 2, is about the virtues of the Quran. Ibn Mas'ud رضي الله عنه, his name Abdullah ibn Mas'ud رضي الله عنه, he became Muslim when he was very young boy, by himself. Yeah, so he was a shepherd looking after sheep, about 13 years old, and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and Abu Bakr passed by him outside the grazing the sheep. And the Prophet and Abu Bakr asked him, you know, in the desert, in the heat, they need some milk from any of the goat. Does any of these have milk? And he said, they're not mine. Even if they have, I can't give you. Subhanallah, the honesty of the business, the honesty of looking after, subhanallah. So the Prophet Abu Bakr were really impressed. So it seems like Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala just inspired the Prophets to show Ibn Mas'ud some miracles. So he says to him, anyone that doesn't produce any milk, anyone that the owners give up on it, yeah? You know, without touching the production line. He says, yeah, there's one over there, it's just nobody cares about it. You can have it, the whole thing. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam went to it and made dua. And touch it, the goat, and make dua. And he says, okay, where is the containers? The address, the fill up. Yeah, in front of his own eyes. And they filled some milk, they drank, they gave him some milk, and they walked away. Look at his curiosity also. He did not leave the work. He stayed till the whole shift is finished, hand over the animals into the farm, locked everything, then walked down to Mecca. And he finds Abu Bakr, he says, what is happening? Who's this man that did this and this and this? He says, oh, this is the messenger of Allah. And straight away, absolutely, he must be a messenger of Allah. And he became Muslim, radiallahu anhu. And he accompanied the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam from that age, the beginning of Islam, very early on. He says, I memorized 70 surah from the mouth of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. 70. If you memorize, wallahi, if you go to Hajj, yeah, if you go to Hajj and you find the imam of all these mosques, not Imam Sudais, no, any imam in any of the mosques, they sit down, ask you to sit down, you sit with them and you correct one ayah, correct one ayah, you feel special. You feel very special. This is the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam sitting, teaching him, not one ayah, 5,000 ayahs, maybe more. Subhanallah. And the Prophet ﷺ used to say, if you want to hear the Quran as it was fresh from Jibreel's mouth, the same voice, the same accent, listen to Ibn Mas'ud when he reads. This is the Prophet saying, if you want to listen to the Quran as fresh as it was revealed, this is the man. And he was one of the very few to give opinion, to give answers to question in the presence of the Prophet ﷺ. Knowledge. In this hadith, the Prophet ﷺ says to him, sit down, read the Quran, I want to listen. Imagine that the Prophet, the Imam of the Haram, asks you to read Quran, I like to listen to your Quran. Not the Imam of the Haram, the Imam of all the Imams. Yeah? The Imam of all the Prophets, all the messengers, even the invisible, unseen creation of Allah, they go to listen to him, sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Yeah, even the unseen creation of Allah, the jinn, they want to listen to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, because it's just so powerful, how he reads, sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So Ibn Mas'ud says, "I read and you listen." He says, "Yeah, I love to hear the Quran. That's what. Huh? I love to hear the recitation of Quran. This is the hadith for us." The Prophet ﷺ loves to hear the recitation of the Quran from nice recitation, nice voice. It should be our way of life too. In the car, in the house, we listen to Quran. Stop this stuff and say, okay, let's listen to some Quran. And you listen, put the headphone on, listen to Quran and cry and make dua and try to understand. Now, alhamdulillah, with translation that you can find. Yeah. So may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us from those who listen to the Quran and understand the Quran and live by the Quran. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make the Quran a witness for us, not against us. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it easy for us and our children to understand the Quran, to recite the Quran, to live by the Quran. وآخر دعوانا الحمد لله رب العالمين صلى الله على نبينا محمد وجزاكم الله خير.